Have you ever wondered how capacitors work in different circuit configurations? Hey guys! In today's video, we're delving into the intriguing realm of capacitors, uncovering how they function in both series and parallel configurations. This is part two of a two-part series. Make sure to watch my other video for part one. Now it's time for a demonstration of capacitors in parallel. To see the capacitors in action, I will attach an LED to the circuit. Let's set up the capacitors in parallel using this breadboard. Insert the red jumper wire into the positive end of the breadboard. Insert the black jumper wire into the negative end of the breadboard. Connect the red alligator clip to the red jumper wire. Connect the black alligator clip to the black jumper wire. To limit the current flowing into the LED, I will use a 450 ohm resistor. Be sure to check my other video if you want to learn how I calculated the resistance. Since I don't have a 450 ohm resistor, I'll use a 470 ohm resistor as a close substitute. Insert the left resistor wire into the same column as the positive end of the breadboard. This is a red LED. It has a voltage drop of 2 volts. Insert the negative end of the LED into the same column as the negative end of the breadboard. This is a 10 microfarad capacitor. Similar to a diode, a capacitor has positive and negative terminals. Insert the longer leg of the capacitor, which is the positive end, into the same column as the positive terminal on the breadboard. Insert the jumper wire to the same row as the capacitor. This is a 100 microfarad capacitor. Insert the longer leg of the capacitor, which is the positive end, into the same column as the positive terminal on the breadboard. Insert the jumper wire to the same row as the capacitor. Insert the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the battery. Insert the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the battery. As shown, the LED lights up when the circuit is closed. Let's check the voltage on the capacitor by using a multimeter. I have the red probe connected to the positive terminal and the black probe connected to the negative terminal of the capacitor. The reading shows around 8.9 volts. What happens when we remove the power? The LED turns off right away. The voltage drops drastically when I remove the power because these capacitors do not store enough charge to see the LED light up for a few seconds after the power is cut. To better visualize this concept, we need a capacitor that can store significantly more charge. This is a 2200 microfarads capacitor. This is larger in size and can store a lot more charge. I will remove the existing capacitors from the breadboard. Connect the first jumper wire to the positive end of the breadboard. Connect the red alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Connect the other end of the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the capacitor. Connect the second jumper wire to the negative end of the breadboard. Connect the black alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Connect the other end of the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the capacitor. Connect the red alligator clip that was connected to the red jumper wire to the positive terminal of the battery. Connect the black alligator clip that was connected to the black jumper wire to the negative terminal of the battery. The LED lights up, which means we have connected the circuit correctly. I'm going to connect the probes of the multimeter to the capacitor so we can see the voltage. I will wait a few seconds so the capacitor gets charged. When I remove the power, the voltage drops but less drastic as the other capacitor. The capacitor powers the LED for a few seconds before it gets dimmed and turns off. Now it's time for a demonstration of capacitors in series. Similar to the capacitors in parallel, I'm going to attach a resistor and an LED to the circuit. Connect the red jumper wire to the positive terminal of the breadboard. Connect the black jumper wire to the negative terminal of the breadboard. Attach the red alligator clip to the red jumper wire. Attach the black alligator clip to the black jumper wire. This is a 470 ohm resistor. Bend the ends of the resistor wires and insert them into the breadboard. This is a red LED. Make sure the positive end of the LED is on the left side. Insert the LED into the breadboard. This is a 10 microfarad capacitor. Just like with the LED, make sure the positive end of the capacitor is positioned on the left side. Insert the capacitor into the breadboard. This is a 100 microfarad capacitor. Insert the capacitor into the breadboard. Connect the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the battery. Connect the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the battery. The LED doesn't light up, why? Let's switch the capacitor to the 2200 microfarad so you can see this interesting phenomena. Now that we have the new capacitor connected, it's time to connect the battery. The LED lights up, but then it slowly fades and turns off. Let's try this again. This time I have attached the capacitor to the multimeter so we can see what's going on. At the start, the reading shows a value close to zero. Now I will attach the battery. As the capacitor charges, its voltage increases. This rising voltage across the capacitor means there's less voltage available for the LED. The current through the LED decreases, causing it to fade. Eventually, the capacitor becomes fully charged. In this state, it acts like an open circuit, meaning no more current flows through the LED. This is why the LED turns off. If you enjoyed this part 2 of capacitors in series and parallel, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you won't miss out on my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.